For this lesson, you need to open the sample file World Sales 6 from your Sample Files folder. In Lesson 513, we're going to talk about data series and categories in depth. But here's an overview that you'll need to understand this lesson. In cells B1 to D1, you can see USA, Europe, and Other. These are the categories for this chart. And in cells A2 to A4, you can see Jan, Feb, Mar. These are the data series for this chart. Each data series contains three values. So the Jan data series contains the values 21,600, 19,200, and 10,800. Each value corresponding to one of the categories, USA, Europe, and Other. Let's now apply a chart filter to show sales only for the Jan and Feb data series. To do this, I'll click on the chart to activate it, and notice that when I do, a group of three icons appears outside the top right corner of the chart, and one of them is a chart filters icon. When I click on chart filters, you can see a list of all of the data series and categories that are being used for this chart. And you can see the Jan, Feb, Mar data series. I'm going to remove the March data series now by clicking the checkbox to the left of Mar. When I click the Apply button, you can see that I'm now only charting sales for January and February. The March data series is hidden. Now let's implement a different requirement by applying chart filters that will show sales for all months, January, February and March, but only in the USA and Europe categories. So once again, I'll click on the chart to activate it, click the Chart Filters button. For the data series, I want sales for January, February and March, so I'll check the March checkbox. And in the categories, I only want USA and Europe, so I'll clear the Other checkbox. And when I click Apply, you can see that I have exactly what I wanted. The data series for January, February and March, but only for the two categories, the USA and Europe. Let's put things back the way they were now by removing all of the filters applied. So once again, I'll activate the chart, click the Chart Filters button, and then I'll click the Select All button for the categories to bring back all three categories. I now click Apply, and the chart's back the way it was at the start of the lesson. There's no need to save this workbook because we haven't changed it in any way. So I'll close Excel and click the Don't Save button. And you've now completed Lesson 510, Apply a Chart Filter.